Hello students, I hope you all doing good. This is part 15 series from class 10 physics, chapter 10 light reflection and refraction. In this video we are going to discuss about linear magnification by spherical lenses or simply magnification by spherical lenses. We are going to discuss about this topic through following steps. First, we are going to see the definition and formula for magnification of spherical lenses. Next, we are going to derive expression for magnification of spherical lenses. Through this expression, we are going to see how the formula for spherical lenses differ from spherical mirrors. Next, we are going to see the summarized table for magnification of spherical lenses. At last, we are going to see the conclusion, that is, we are going to see some important points regarding magnification of spherical lenses. Okay, so let's start with definition and formula for magnification of spherical lenses. Generally, magnification represents the word size of anything. Okay, so here we are going to see magnification produced by spherical lenses. Usually spherical lenses forms images with respect to object. So magnification by spherical lenses helps to know the size of image based on the size of object or with respect to the size of object. So for our understanding, let's break and read the definition for magnification by spherical lenses. Here is the definition. Let's read. The magnification of spherical lenses gives the relative extent to which the, that is comparing to which the image of an object is magnified. Here image of an object is magnified represent size of image with respect to the object size. So based on this concept, magnification of spherical lenses is expressed in ratios. Before seeing this expression, you must know size of the image is representing the height of the image. Okay, and size of the object is representing the height of the object. Yes, so let's see the ratio for magnification. Magnification is equal to size or height of image over size or height of object. Now this ratio is expressed in formula, that is M is equal to H1 by H0. Here M represent magnification, H1 represent height of the image and H0 represent height of the object. Clear? Next, this magnification of spherical lenses is also expressed based upon the distance of image and distance of object. So the ratio for magnification of spherical lenses can also be written as image distance over object distance, and the formula for this ratio is M is equal to V by U. V represent image distance and U represent object distance. Using these two formula, we can arrive the following formula. M is equal to H1 by H0 is equal to V by U. Okay. These are the common formulas for magnification of spherical lenses. Next, expression for magnification of spherical lenses and spherical mirror. You know, spherical lenses are two types, convex lens and concave lens, and spherical mirror are also two types, concave mirror and convex mirror. So we got two expression for each. Okay, so let's start with first expression from convex lens. This is the ray diagram for image formation in convex lens. You know, magnification is equal to height of the image over height of the object. So we are going to write height of the image and height of the object according to new Cartesian sign convention. Okay, so M is equal to, where is the height of the image? Here the height of the image lies on the negative side of the y-axis. Yes, so we write minus h1 over height of the object. Here the height of the object lies on the positive side of the y-axis, so we write h0. Okay, and you also know another formula for magnification is image distance over object distance. So where is the image? Image lies on the positive side of the x-axis. So we write plus v over minus u. Why minus u? Here the object distance lies on the negative side of the x-axis. So we write v over minus u. So using these two formula, we can write m is equal to minus h1 by h0 is equal to minus v by u. See, here we got minus sign and here also we got minus sign. So we have minus sign on both the sides. We're going to cancel these two minus sign so that we get m is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to v by u. Clear? Next, concave lens. Look at concave lens. This is the ray diagram for image formation in concave lens. Once again, you have two formulas for magnification. See, height of the image over height of the object and image distance over object distance. So what is the height of the image? Height of the image is erect, so it lies along the positive side of the y-axis. So we write h1 by h0. Where is h0? Height of the object is also erect, upright, so it is also lie on the positive side of the y-axis. So h1 over h0 both are in positive signs. Once again, image distance. Where is the image? It lies along the negative side of the x-axis. So it is minus b. Minus v over object distance. An object also lies along the negative side of the x-axis. So it is minus u. Okay. So comparing these two equations, we can write m is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to v by u, because both the minus sign get cancelled in v by u. Okay, so we write m is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to v by u. So here both in convex lens formula and concave lens formula are same. So we have arrived a formula for magnification of spherical lenses. M is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to v by u. So clear? So this is the formula for magnification of spherical lenses. Now look at expression for magnification of concave mirror. Here this is the ray diagram for magnification of concave mirror. Once again, we have written both the formulas for magnification. So magnification is equal to height of image over height of object, and also it is expressed as image distance over object distance. Yes, now we are going to write the height of the image and height of the object according to the new Cartesian sign convention. So m is equal to height of the image. H1 lies along the negative side of the y-axis. So m is equal to minus h1 over h0. Where is the h0? H0 lies along the positive side of the y-axis. So I have written m is equal to minus h1 over h0. Clear? Next, image distance. Where is the image distance? Image distance lies on the negative side of the x-axis. So minus v over object distance. Even object distance lies on the negative side of the x-axis. So minus u. Now both the minus get cancelled and we write m is equal to v by u. Okay, now let's equate equation 1 and 2. We get m is equal to minus h1 by h0 is equal to v by u. See, usually the negative sign should come on the right hand side of the equation. So we need to change the negative sign. For that, we are going to multiply by minus on both the sides. That is left hand side and right hand side, we are going to multiply minus. So that we get minus into minus plus. So we write h1 by h0 is equal to, Here we multiply one more minus sign. So we write here as minus V by U. Clear? So we arrived a formula for magnification for concave mirror. Next, magnification by convex mirror. This is the ray diagram for image formation in convex mirror. Once again, we have written the formula for magnification according to sign convention. M is equal to height of the image. Where is the height of the image? Height of the image is erect, upright. So it lies on the positive side of the y-axis. So it is plus h1 by, and height of the object is also upright. So it also lies on the positive side of the y-axis. So it is h0. So both are in positive sign. Next, m is equal to image distance over object distance. So where is the image? Image lies along the positive side of the x-axis. So it is v positive v over object distance. Object lies on the negative side of the x-axis. So it is minus u. So comparing these two equations, we get m is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to minus v by u. So these two formulas are same. So for concave mirror, m is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to minus v by u. And for convex mirror also, m is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to minus v by u. So at last we have a common formula for magnification of spherical mirror. M is equal to h1 by h0 is equal to minus v by u. So formula for magnification of spherical lenses differ from magnification of spherical mirror by having a negative sign in image distance over object distance. But here there is no negative sign. So this is the difference between magnification of spherical lenses from magnification of spherical mirror. Clear? Next, summarize table for magnification of spherical lenses. You know, magnification of spherical lenses got two formulas. M is equal to V by U and another formula is M is equal to H1 by H0. So this formula M is equal to V by U is used to know the nature of the image, and M is equal to H1 by H0 is used to know the size of the image or height of the image. Okay, so look at the nature of image. Here nature of images are classified into two types. One is virtual and erect and the other one is real and inverted. If the image is virtual and erect, then magnification value will be in positive. If the image is real and inverted, then the magnification value will be in negative. Okay, so let's see how it is possible. For example, V is equal to, that is, image distance is equal to minus 2. Since the virtual images are formed on the same side of the object, that is along the negative side of the y-axis, so they have given V is equal to minus 2, comma U is equal to minus 1. Even object lies on the negative side of the x-axis, so they have given U is equal to minus 1. Now you know the formula, M is equal to V by U, which is minus 2 by minus 1. Minus 2 by minus 1. Now these two minus signs get cancelled. So we have 2 as an answer. That is positive 2. M is equal to positive 2. It means the value we have arrived is in positive value. Next, if the image is real and inverted. So real images are formed on the right hand side of the lens, that is along the positive side of the x-axis, and the image is inverted, it lies on the negative side of the y-axis. Okay, so I said image is formed on the positive side of the x-axis, so they have given V is equal to plus 2 comma U is equal to minus 1. Why? The object lies on the negative side of the x-axis, so they have given minus 1. Now write down the formula, M is equal to V by U, which is equal to plus 2 over minus 1, which is equal to minus 2. So we have arrived value m is equal to minus 2. So the value is in negative sign. M is negative. There are three kinds of sizes formed by the lenses. First one, enlarged image, then same size image, then diminished size image. Enlarged size image, that is enlarged from the object. Same size image, it is at equal size of the object. Diminished size image, that is smaller than the object. Okay, so if an image is enlarged image, then magnification is greater than 1. If image is same size as like object, then m is equal to 1. Next, diminished size image. If the image is smaller, then magnification is lesser than 1. So let's see how this is possible by doing some examples. H1 is equal to 8 and H0 is equal to 4. That is, m is equal to height of the image over height of the object, which is equal to 8 by 4. 4 2s are 8. So we got 2 as an answer. M is equal to 2, which is greater than 1. Then the image formed here is enlarged image. Next, height of the image is 4 and height of the object is 4. So magnification is equal to H1 by H0 is equal to 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. So m is equal to 1, which is also equal to 1. Next, H1 is equal to 4, H0 is equal to 8. That is height of the image over height of the object, which is equal to 4 by 8. So by simplifying the 4 by 8, we get 1 by 2. Further simplification, we get 0.5. So m is equal to 0.5, which is lesser than 1. It means the image is diminished or smaller than the object. If you understand the summarized table, you can solve the problems very easily. So we are under conclusion. We are going to see some important points regarding magnification of spherical lenses. Okay, sign of the magnification. That is, to know whether m is positive or negative, we can determine that by knowing the height of the object and height of the image. If the height of the object is positive, then m will be positive. If height of the image is negative, then the value for m will be in negative. Clear? So consider height of the image. Here the image is erect or upright image, so it lies always on the positive side of the y-axis. Yes, then the magnification will be in positive value. So remember, virtual and erect image gives positive value for m. See, we have seen that in this summarized table. See, virtual and erect image gives positive value. So by looking at the erect image, you can directly say that the m value will be in positive, because the height of the image lies on the positive side of the y-axis. So if the image is erect, then you can say the m value will be in positive. So sign of the magnification completely depends upon the height of the image or height of the object. Clear? Once again, look here. In case of real and inverted image, here inverted image is formed along the negative side of the y-axis. Yes, then the magnification will have negative value for real and inverted image. So by using the height of the image, you can determine the sign of the magnification. Next point to remember, concave lens always forms virtual and erect image. So if the image is erect, then the m value will be positive. So concave lens always have positive magnification value. Clear? And in case of convex lens, there are two kinds of nature of image. One is real and inverted, another one is virtual and erect. This virtual and erect image is formed under exceptional condition. So under one condition, it gives magnification value as positive value. In other cases, it produces magnification value as a negative value. Based on the size of the image, magnification is determined whether it is greater than 1 or lesser than 1 or equal to 1. So, in case of concave lens always form diminished size image, that is smaller size image. So, it is always lesser than 1. Magnification is always lesser than 1 for concave lens since it produces diminished size image. In case of convex lens, it forms 3 kinds of images: enlarged image, same size image and diminished size image. If the image is enlarged, then magnification is greater than 1. If the image is same size like object, then M is equal to 1. If the image is diminished, then magnification is lesser than 1. And most important point, magnification has no unit. For example, H1 is equal to 10 cm, H0 is equal to 5 cm. So, H1 over H0 is 10 cm over 5 cm. So, both the units get cancelled and we finally arrive no unit. So, magnification has no units. Same for magnification expressed in image distance over object distance. Here also magnification has no units. Clear? I hope this video will be useful for you. If you like it, click the like button. If you are ready to subscribe Editing Physics, then subscribe it now. Give your feedback in comment section. See you soon in next video. Good luck.